morning the right way. Gonna be great, gonna be a good day. This is Jason Lauren on Melbourne's Nova 100.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to your Tuesday.
Oh, good morning.
That's
it
right.
Feels like Monday, but it
doesn't
is
matter.
A Tuesday. And guess what? Winter is well and truly here.
I know, but it's all right because we're almost halfway through the week.
Jeez, it was howling last night.
I know, tell me about it.
I thought the house was going to blow over.
I thought I had a burglar.
I thought, batten down the hatches, Paul. We're in strife here. Yeah. House is about to take off. How was the wind bay side?
Wind bay side was pretty strong. We're clearing out the house at the moment for the big move. So we had a pile of stuff stacked up underneath.
Funny you mentioned that.
What?
No, we'll talk about it later.
We'll get to it.
No, just your skip bin. We saw your skip bin.
We went through it.
Oh, no.
Great detail.
Oh, no.
It was many questions to ask.
Did you see the kids in there? Because they were almost in there on Sunday.
Many questions about some of the things we found in the skip bin.
See Lou's hand just coming up from underneath the rubble?
Many questions.
That's quite invasive, someone going through your bin.
A man's skip bin says a lot about a man.
Oh, doesn't it just?
Yeah.
There's a lot of shit in there, wasn't there?
Yeah, well, there's some really interesting things we saw in the skip bin.
I can imagine the text.
A lot of new things as well.
I can imagine the text exchange between you two.
We were sitting next to each other at dinner discussing it.
There was a theme of things you seem to have thrown out, which doesn't surprise me. We should talk about that maybe later today. Bin chat. We love bin chat.
We do love bin chat. Can we also chat? What did you two get up to last night? I got a photo of you two.
I was drinking
and a
tea.
Party Susan.
Yes.
Lazy Susan.
Well, she was in party form last night,
she
let
was.
Me tell you.
I was drinking tea, but in that photo I noticed I had three glasses of Chardonnay in front of me.
Yes.
Why did I have three?
Where were you two last night? Did you carry on after the footy?
Oh. We went to Cheap and Cheerful Chinese.
Pacific House. Shout out to Jeffrey.
Should we
always gives us the big
does
table.
Does Jeffrey
in the
do those amazing things you see on Instagram where they spin the Lazy Susan and then
they
quickly
rip it?
Put the tablecloth underneath?
Nah.
Oh, that's incredible.
No, but
did Jeffrey do that?
Paul called ahead to make sure we got a Peking duck because there's been the bird flu and so there's a shortage on duck apparently, but we got one.
Well, we walked in.
Oh, hang on.
We walked in and he said there's only enough for eight Peking duck pancakes, right?
But there was extra. Where did
and
that
then
come from?
All of a sudden, this 16. Tray of goodness just arrived out of nowhere.
I know.
They found another duck.
I know.
Where did they find it?
That doesn't matter.
Sounds like a table.
Maybe
crispy
in your skip
it was
bin.
Beautiful.
Maybe it was a table that didn't finish their duck.
Nah, Jeffrey wouldn't do that to us. Anyway, we had a great day. We were celebrating the king. You know, birthdays are to be celebrated.
King's BD.
Oh, the king would have liked it.
The king would have loved
imagine
it.
Imagine him getting his sausage fingers around a duck pancake.
What time, just out of curiosity, did the king's
fingers.
Birthday celebrations finish?
When the staff were vacuuming between my feet.
It was like 10 to 9. It was very early.
They were vacuuming under the table and we turned around and there was not another person in the restaurant besides the staff sitting there playing on their phones. And as we left, I was like, sorry, Jeffrey. He was like, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. As we walked out the door, it literally went like they locked the door. So we definitely, even if we forgot something, couldn't come back in.
That's the worst feeling, isn't it? So you guys want us to go? No. You're
right. It's fine. Stay here. We're just going to vacuum under your feet.
So that cool little cart that goes around with all the dumplings.
No, it wasn't Yum Cha.
Oh, no. Is that Sunday? Yum Cha?
Well, traditionally, but the dainty Szechuan up the street is doing it every day, apparently.
We must go.
A daily cart?
No, we are Pacific House family.
Yeah.
You know when you got two Chinese restaurants in the suburb, and you got to stay loyal to one?
Any chance we can get that cart pushed through here?
That'd be good.
Oh.
Today would be good.
Roll in the steamed cart. Mm.
After all the green teas I had last night, I'm going to need breakfast.
Were you
wing
like a racehorse? I was. Up every half hour.
From all the green tea.
More green tea.
Hey, guys, huge show coming up today. We need to find out what's going on with our boy, Track, because he was down at the end of the first quarter.
What did you do that for?
I don't know.
Is that what they sound like?
So, with the footy last night.
Sorry. Someone's going to need to explain. What's happening here.
What do you mean? Can I just say?
Why are you being a turkey?
With the with Track in the game.
Yes. Is this a bet? Because you barrack for Melbourne and you barrack for Collingwood.
We
and
may have made
won.
A bet yesterday. I said every time we mention the game, the loser has to do
let's
a magpie
not go
sound.
When we mention the game.
Oh, it's
let's
a magpie. Yeah. We should get the magpie woman on. Swoop.
Have we got a sound of a magpie there?
Remember the magpie woman?
Here we go. You do yours.
Sounds like a turkey. Oh, it's not bad.
That's pretty good, isn't it?
It's not bad. It's not bad. So as I was saying,
it's going to get real old.
It is, yeah.
Poor track.
I know.
End of the first quarter. Oh, did not look good. And then left in an ambulance.
I know. It looks like it's his ribs.
Mm.
But in that area where he got a knee in the back, by the look of it, it can be nasty.
He was in the hands of my father. I wish him all the very best.
I saw
your dad. We were trying to call your
dad
to get some info.
See you, Dad. We'll see you in 6 months.
Yeah.
Poor thing.
So, look, we're going to dive into that. Mason Cox is going to be joining us after 7 o'clock this morning.
We were with, get there, Lauren, Peter Dacos yesterday.
Oh, God, his son had a blinder.
I was going to say Nick Dacos. No, Peter Dacos. Peter. We were with Peter Dacos at the football yesterday. One of his sons got hurt too. That's the end of my story. Yeah. I don't know if it was Nick or Josh.
Great story, bro.
She kept getting her Dacos is confused yesterday.
The whole game. I was like, which one's that?
Peter, why are you not out on the field?
Yeah.
Why are you in the bar with us?
I got confused again this morning.
All right, let's get into it.
We're going to need breakfast.
6:07 morning. This is Nova. It is Jason Lauren. We're doing a thanks to our mates at What If It Is Aussie for travel. And yes, we are live at the Nova Studios this morning in South Melbourne. Will we stay here today or will we leave for this?
Hide and seek.
Hide and hide and hide and seek.
Nova's $250,000 hide and seek. The search for Jason DeLauren could begin at any moment, Melbourne.
That's right. We've started the show here. Will we still be here at 9 o'clock or will we be making our way to the location? It is Melbourne's
game week.
It is game week and it is all thanks to our mates at Lexus of Brighton. You can make a dynamic entrance with the Lexus LBX City SUV at Lexus of Brighton, Nepean Highway. I drove past it the other day. They've got some nice cars.
Jazzy
in there.
Cars.
Very, very nice cars.
Fast cars,
getaway cars.
So here's the go. At some time this week, we will leave the studio.
Mm-hmm.
We will go to a location. We can tell you it is not a school.
It could happen during the day.
It is not a hospital. And it is not a house.
Mm-hmm. And we might pop up at any time saying, Melbourne, we're here.
And when we do, the game begins. $250,000. The faster you find us, the more you win, because the money will count down.
Yes, the money will drop.
So?
Second by second, minute by minute.
Don't be sitting there going, we'll get them tomorrow, because you won't be playing for as much.
Yeah. You want to get out of the blocks with this one. So you want to know, the key to winning as much money as possible is knowing when the game starts.
Exactly. Now, let me run through a couple of things that you need to know, right?
Some game house
time
rules.
Is 6 a.m. to 6 p.m.
Yes.
All right? So after 6 p.m.
Don't come looking for us at midnight.
No.
We'll be schlepping.
On the Rosehose. Give us a break. We're going to be revealing clues on the air here at Nova or on the Nova socials. And we want you to keep us updated. So if you think you know where we are, we want you to text us.
What's our phone number?
Our text number. Save this in your phone, Loz. Go into contacts.
I still don't know what the actual phone number is, but I'll put the text in.
Yep. So you hit plus to add a contact. Yep.
Yep.
The number is 0459.
0459.
888.
888.
100.
100. Add number.
That's got a
number again. 0459. 888. 100. And remember,
if you think you know where we are,
you knock on that
text
door. Yep. And knock on that door and say, Jason, Lauren, come out wherever you are, and the money could be yours.
I'm excited and I'm nervous.
Pack my bag.
Have you?
Did you go past the location?
Be careful.
I can't believe you said...
It's not a trap.
Because I'm surprised you went all the way there.
It's a long weekend.
You had time. I wouldn't expect...
I did a drive-by.
I would have been shocked to see you in this part.
I did a drive-by, and I did not do a drive-by in my car because I was so paranoid.
Good. How'd you feel after driving past it?
Particularly anxious.
Very, very careful what
you're saying. Just as anxious as I feel right now in this conversation.
Yeah, right. Do we think we've picked a good spot?
I don't want to say anything more. We're so paranoid in our house. My mum texted and said, because in hide and seek, we want to eat well.
Yep.
And my mum on the weekend said, do you want me to do a cook-up for you? So you've got some healthy things to take in.
Yeah.
And Paul said, don't reply. Oh, it could be a trick.
A trap.
And I was like, it's my mom. And he said, don't reply. Don't tell her a thing.
Well, here's
because
one.
Because she might be just, you know, trying to suss out for her friends what day you're going in.
Here's one for you. You know, Andrew, the footy nuffy across the road, right? So he works in insurance, I think. It's money, right?
Sounds sus.
Well, he was saying
sounds dodgy
that the girls at work who work in the investigative department, right?
Investigative.
That's the one.
Are the ones that try and find insurance frauds.
Yes, yeah, yeah, yeah. So they were saying to Andrew, hey, if you text Jace when he's in there, just Jace, and he replies, we can track your phone to see where we got a ping.
No.
No.
Well, we're not taking our phones in.
Phones must stay out.
Apparently, I don't know if it's all above board. He said technically they won't because it's illegal, but apparently they can.
Hey, people are already testing out the text line. Shoot us a text, 0459 888 100. What are they saying? Anything interesting?
Hello.
Oh, that's
good, good. Oh, it's as good as your chat in the opener.
Strong, strong start. I was at the footy yesterday, walking in, thousands of people. Record, record. You know the guys that sell the records?
Yeah.
And he goes, hey, Clint, Stannis, you might need one of these to read when you go into hide and seek tomorrow. And I'm like, and then this woman, top of her voice, she goes, nah, Dale, don't worry. He's not going in. He's worthless.
Like, true words have never been spoken.
She's right. I am worthless, Dale.
Who's going to rate the sport if you come into hide and seek?
I've got to swim at the swim championships tomorrow night.
Is it tomorrow night?
We should talk about that. Whereabouts was this guy that was giving
you prep? Are we going to watch that together, Jay?
Just outside Jollymont Station.
Oh, on the way to the footy.
Yeah.
Well, where else did they sell footy records?
No, yesterday's game.
In Gels Park?
Oh.
So if you're just tuning in, because Collingwood beat Melbourne every time... Stupid Jace mentions the football. Clint has to make a magpie noise. You were very upset watching the football yesterday, and it all makes sense.
Because people were getting in my grill, and I didn't like
no,
it.
Yeah, no, he was not fun to be around.
Oh, okay. Let's dive
wasn't
into
funny.
Let's dive into your day at the footy and your confusion.
Oh, stop talking about
the
footy.
About the Dacos boys coming up next on Nova. You just shot a message off the track.
I did.
Proof
just
of
a little
life
check
after.
In.
Oh, poor Christian
Both
Petrarca.
Of our boys are sick.
I know.
Not in a bad way. Not in a good way,
Cox
sorry.
Got injured a few
I know.
Weeks ago.
This was the moment yesterday.
This happened right on the quarter time siren in the marking contest. A big knee from Darcy Moore got him right in the ribs. He was in pain immediately. Christian Petrarca went to ground, eventually got up and tried to make his way to the quarter time huddle, but was in so much discomfort.
Yeah, he poor thing. Yeah, he it looked nasty, didn't it?
Just I thought they were about to bring out the bloody golf buggy with the stretcher on.
So he got jabbed at quarter time, tried to play on, but just couldn't.
Yeah, because it looked like he was trying to get back out there.
And they couldn't even sort of lift his arms.
Really?
And then got sent off to hospital late in the game.
Yeah, I saw him going in an ambulance.
His beautiful mum giving him a kiss goodbye.
Sweet.
What? Because your dad's trainer at the D's.
Yeah.
What did he say his mood was like?
Oh, he's pretty disappointed, obviously.
Mm. Yeah.
Disappointed mood in the rooms afterwards because they should have responded following a near 100-point loss and they capitulated again, Jace.
Mate, the Pies were so quick, just out of the gates straight away.
Funny though, because Clint and I went to the footy together yesterday. We were in a box in a corporate suite.
Must have been us.
Lucky enough to be entertained by Smile Solutions.
Smile Solutions, yes. Dentist. We were smiling all day, weren't we? Ding, 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 white teeth everywhere.
I was level 4 man of the people.
Sitting next to Nathan Buckley, hardly.
Oh,
hardly man of the people.
Rose over.
And when I got to the football, it was like a split box. It was sort of half Melbourne and half Collingwood. But the Collingwood fans were the ones that were like, oh, no, today won't be our day. We've got too many injuries. And then Collingwood just came out absolutely steaming.
But they were flying. Mm. They'd get that ball from one end to the other in a matter of seconds.
We had royalty in our box. Royalty is in the Macedonian marvel.
Mm.
The father of Nick and Josh Dacos, Peter Dacos.
Peter Dacos.
And
what was he doing in there with the pearly
white?
Very,
very amusing happened. So I think the Channel 7 cameramen were trying to find Peter Dacos through the match. You know how they like to get cutaways of the day?
Yeah.
Anyway, they
His
finally,
was there?
Finally Colin? Found him late in deep in the last quarter. Anyway, he's sitting next to one Lauren.
Oh,
and
no.
Lauren is just chewing his ear off. Choo, 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 choo.
And it came up on the big screen?
Came up.
Oh, yes!
I didn't notice. I just kept talking.
Peter looked right into the conversation as well.
The boys took great pleasure out of someone taking screen recording
he
of me chewing
get
ear.
A word in.
Can I see the footage? Did anybody get the footage?
I was trying
to... Oh, Chaz has got the footage.
I was trying to work out which one was Nick and which one was Josh, because one had a corky.
Yes.
Nick had the coloured boots on.
And Nick went off a little injured in the last... What? Look at his reaction.
What?
He is not giving you any second of the day, and you look like a fan.
Show me.
Oh, Peter.
Don't. That does look like I'm chewing his ear off.
Oh, my God. You look like...
No. We had a lovely chat. You should get him on.
We should.
Get him on and see if I actually chewed his ear off.
You know what?
Because that's unfair.
There's only one thing that would have topped that, if it was the halftime kiss cam.
How good's the kiss cam?
Do they have the kiss cam still?
Yeah, I was watching it.
At quarter time was the kiss cam.
Oh, it was amazing.
Yeah, I loved it. What about that woman that was like, no, I'm not kissing him. No, I don't even think we're supposed to be here together. Please take me off this screen.
Imagine if they found ACOS during that.
Oh.
I would have gone in for a smooch. You got to play along. That's the rules of kiss cam.
Yeah, you have to. Yeah.
Doesn't matter.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay.
Thank goodness you weren't sitting next to me.
Oh, I would have macked on with you, Stannis.
Rules are rules. Let's get naughty.
Naughty, naughty.
6:40.
Guys, Kanye West and wife Bianca are back in the headlines. They love a headline, don't they?
They do.
Do you think they froth on it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well, they're frothing on something else as well.
Oh.
Because... this one, the reason they're in the headlines is because there has been a lawsuit filed by Kanye West's former assistant. It makes plenty of wild claims in there.
Right.
Including this one, which doesn't really surprise me. Kanye West and his wife, Bianca Censori, have engaged in a 5-person orgy, is part of the claims.
Have they?
That's a lot of work.
5 people.
Good on them.
Yeah.
Imagine trying to keep 5
people happy. I'm not surprised by that.
Got to give Cheryl a bit of time now a bit of Tina. Mm.
I'm just not Juanita, surprised
I've been
by
neglecting
that at all.
Her.
Who
then
else?
Back to Bianca. Because you remember your
partner.
Well,
why is it him and fight for?
Yeah.
How do you know it's
just surrounding yourself with
him?
And
I'm not finished. I'm not finished. Oh, Stephen, I didn't see you there. Like,
now I'm finished.
Not at you, Steve.
You're not into group sessions?
Just seems like a lot of work. I mean, I wouldn't say no, but...
Have you ever been propositioned into a group setting?
Actually, no. You ever done one?
Whoa. No, I haven't, Clint.
Okay.
Have you?
No 5-on-1 action?
No, not in its strict form, no.
What do you mean?
What do you mean in its strict form?
What, have you ordered 3 in one night?
No, I haven't.
No, we're going to need more info
absolutely.
On that.
Absolutely. We are not moving on from that. What do you mean in its strict form?
Why didn't you guys ask me?
Have you ever done one?
Oh. No.
Please, though, you barely hold hands.
I just wanted you to ask me, though.
Yeah, no, we didn't want to waste the time.
I am vanilla.
Can we go back to the multicoloured milkshake over here? What do you mean?
Not in its strict form.
Oh, no. There was just someone else present in the room.
Watching you?
What do you mean?
Didn't realise they were there.
Did you ever witness?
Didn't realise they were there.
So you were with someone.
Yes.
And there was a third in the room.
Yes.
You didn't realise they were there and they were watching.
Yes.
Why?
Well, I didn't realise they were there.
But why,
and
why,
then
why
I'm
didn't
like,
they say
this
anything?
This is almost a little bit akin to a...
Well, no.
A trio.
Technically they would have to...
Exactly. They needed to participate.
Yeah.
Where, were they behind the curtain or where were they?
In the bed opposite.
Oh, and it was multi.
Mm. And were they awake watching?
Mm.
What, were you in a hostel?
No, I wasn't, but it was akin to that. It was like an Airbnb, let's just say.
Oh, question. With twin beds.
Yes. Were you halfway through when you realised they were there?
No post.
Oh, well, that's good.
And the creep didn't say anything.
Didn't say one thing. I felt sullied.
Yeah, I don't know about that. That's a bit on the nose, I reckon.
Hey,
not for me.
What are you into?
Me?
13, 24, 10.
Oh.
Watching?
Me? No. No, I wouldn't be lying in the twin beds watching. No. No.
I've got a friend whose name I will suppress.
Smart.
He was dating a girl for a while who used to love doing circle work with her tongue on his navel.
What? The belly button is a no-go zone for me.
It's a sacred place.
I don't like it being poked, touched, rubbed.
She used to lick his navel.
She used to tongue his belly button. In she goes, and used to love it.
I don't mind a hoon on the earlobe.
A nibble?
I don't.
What's wrong?
Just
a nibble or a tongue?
No. Like a
nibble. I just woke up. Right? I don't need to hear this. I've literally just got out of bed.
Maybe this is the time you do.
I haven't even been up and at him for a full hour.
Maybe this is when people are out there nibbling. If they do a little bite on the earlobe. Yeah. And then I did.
And
I
was a little tongue?
Well, I was with one girl that would then slide the tongue in.
Into the cavity? Earlobe.
Yeah.
Really?
I mean, if it was just a quick in and out, I don't mind it, but I don't want to sit in there lingering.
Yeah, it gets a bit squelchy.
Yes.
Oh,
it's like listening to a shell. I can hear the beat.
I'm not into this chat. One bit.
Let's see if Melbourne is. 13, 24, 10.
Does Jace make you sick? He's the phoner.
You're on the air with Miss Prude. We would like to know, Melbourne, what are you into? Oh, you know what else? I like when the girl wears your shirt. You know, like the next morning. Like
that's
there.
Hot.
Yeah. Hey, there you go. That's welcome hot. To the party.
I imagine.
Oh, God. Brody.
Oh, no.
The thumb, our executive producer.
Is Don't yours, ask him. I've already had enough of you two.
Is yours legal? Can you say yours on the air?
He's got a list as long as he's on.
I know. What are you? Oh, God.
This is a guy that I know.
So it's you.
Is it by saying that?
Yeah. Me. Yeah.
He was very much into peach iced tea, and it had always to be peach iced tea. He would run a small foot bath for his partner, who's now his wife, and he would fill it up with peach iced tea, and then she would dip her feet into it for about 10 minutes, have a good soak of it, and then take the feet out, and they would do other stuff. But
what? He'd suck her toes once had been soaking in peach dye tea.
Was this
and it had to be peach. He didn't like the other flavours. It had to be peach.
Was it Fergie? It sounds like a Fergie job. She was a toe sucker. She loved it.
He'd run a small peach dye tea bath for her.
That's gross.
And he liked it a lot, obviously, but then it became more like special occasions because it was a regular thing.
Well,
and then
married.
He's like, special occasions.
Yeah, it's expensive.
Oh, that's a lot of work. But we're finished. All right, now I've got to empty the Remington foot spa.
Mm. sticky post-use as well.
Yeah.
Peach dye tea in a Remington foot spa.
Turn it on. What a bubble as well. 13, 24, 10. We've got free stuff to go on return.
Mm.
You can remain completely anonymous. What gets you going?
Yeah, whether it's watching, tonguing the navel.
Oh.
What?
Sucking a
peachy toe.
13, 24, 10. Lauren thinks no one's going to call. Let's see if Melbourne's happy to admit what they're into. You are listening to Nova and our Naughty Naughty 640 this morning. Topic is, what are you into?
Yes. What is your flavour, would you say?
To go to in the boudoir.
Stacey in Fitzroy North, good morning.
Good morning.
What is your go-to party trick?
The neck. Kisses on the neck.
Oh.
Nibbles or kisses?
No, kisses.
Yeah.
What kisses. Is it okay?
Do you like giving them or receiving the kisses?
No, receiving the kisses.
Oh. Like a hickey? Fair. What about when you sit on a hickey? Yeah.
No. Not
gentle.
Not the hickey. Just a little. On the neck.
And do you them like working their way up?
Oh.
Or around?
Yeah. No, up on the neck, then up to the ear.
Mm.
And then.
Back down.
Then, or.
Like circle work.
But.
It's a full marathon.
Okay.
Yeah, right.
You two boys are loving this, aren't you?
I am.
Well, she sounded like she was loving it when she described it, to be honest.
Mm.
I just thought of another one that happened on a mate of mine.
Go.
Well,
come on.
You say all kinds of things, so if you're not sure, I would suggest you probably can't.
Yeah. I'll whisper. Talk amongst yourself.
I'll talk amongst myself. These two are loving this. Hang on, he's whispering in Clint's ear. Oh, Clint's little hands are shaking. And it's taking a long time to tell this story. I don't know. Clint, can you say?
I don't think so.
All right,
can you
I'll
give
say
us
it
a sneak peek?
It's a bit role play.
It is a little role play. Yeah. You know what? We'll get to it in a sec. We'll first take some more calls.
Erica in Lilydale.
Devilish people, how are you?
Well, good. How are you,
Erica?
I am wonderful.
Get it, Erica.
I absolutely love the sound. If someone's got a nipple ring or a tongue ring, if you scrape it along your teeth, the sound that it makes. There's something about that sound. I don't know. It's very
a nipple ring on your teeth.
Yeah, so if you scrape them on your teeth, the sound it makes on your teeth.
Erica.
Wow.
I know.
Erica.
Do you have one of those piercings, Erica?
Like Billie Eilish's song just before. I'm like, oh my God, that's very similar.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
No, well, what's her new song? What's
yeah, Eric, can we
lunchtime?
Is
it called lunchtime?
Lunch. I am.
Lunch. Not lunchtime, just lunch.
Erica, when was the last time you experienced something like this?
Oh, it was a while ago now. It was a while ago. But if I've got a friend that's got a tongue ring, I'll get them to scrape it on. Actually, oh no, I lie. It happened on Thursday. One of the girls I worked with, I made her do it purely because I liked the sound. I said, can you just do it once?
It's only Tuesday.
I know.
Hang on, you got one of your friends too.
It's not the best for the tooth, but it's good for me.
It wouldn't be good for your teeth.
Erica,
metal box
you
on
are
your
a 10 out
it's
of 10.
Good for me, so
oh, yeah.
Good.
Yeah, Erica.
Erica, you're a hoot.
You're a VIP caller. You get through any time, all right?
Congratulations.
Woohoo!
She's a lot. Let's go to Anonymous.
I'm exhausted.
On 13, 24, 10, and Anonymous, what are you into?
Oh, are you talking to me, darling?
I am indeed, darling.
Darling.
Ah, hello, darling. Well, I like to go to adult erotic parties as a single woman.
Oh.
How about that?
Do you wear a mask?
What? Do I wear a mask, like a COVID mask?
No, like no, like Batman.
No. Well, sometimes there's like themes, like dress-up themes, and there might be like a masquerade ball.
Yeah, that's what I mean. What's... I thought people went anonymously to those things with masks.
Yes, yeah.
Like,
oh, look, I'm not really anonymous. I mean, those people that know me know that I go to these things.
Yeah. Do you have some sort of name?
No, I'll just go by my own name.
Okay. Yeah, right.
And what are the themes?
Oh, look, there's been under the sea.
So oh, what'd you wear to that?
Mermaid. Well, you could dress up as a mermaid and have nice little sparkly boob in hot.
Oh, yeah.
Or the a mermaid.
The shell bra.
Yeah, right, the shell bra.
Yeah. Or there might be devils and angels, and you might dress up as a devil, or you might dress up as an angel.
Oh,
you
so back an angel.
Back in the under the sea one, like if you meet someone, do you just start macking on with a prawn? With like Nemo. Whatever they're dressed up as? Like
macking on with a prawn. Look, darling, I've got better taste than prawns.
Yeah.
Definitely not sharks either, let me tell you.
Oh, not no sharks.
I love the people that listen to this show. My God.
Mm. Okay.
It's a whole different world
I
out there.
I
want to
know what other costumes in the Under the Sea party.
Well, just quickly, how often are these events happening?
Well, there's the best events are the ones that are actually run by single women themselves.
Oh.
And so these women run these events safely for women to come to. And so it's mainly couples, you know, hetero couples. And then they allow maybe 5 single males that are well vetted to come.
Oh,
and
yes.
Single women can usually come free or for a small fee. But it's somewhere that they can come safely knowing that it's all consensual.
Yes.
People will ask before touching you.
Yeah, right.
They will ask if it's okay to give you a compliment even. Like, it's all very, very, very consensual, which you
yeah,
think
well, that's
that
what
you go to a nightclub.
Yeah. Is this all done in-house, or do you go home for the activities?
Well, look, some people organise things privately. You know, you might connect on some sort of app and create your own little party, because not everybody's into...
Yeah. Yes. Maybe I'll pitch it
mermaids.
To Lou.
On not everyone's into mermaids. Oh,
that's a good idea.
Yeah, I'll go, Lou, where do you sit on an under-the-sea dance?
I want to know what other themes there were.
So, my mate...
Just one more question.
Okay.
Any other...
I
got one more question.
Okay.
Any other fun themes
like
other than
it.
Angels and Devils and Under the Sea?
Oh, absolutely. There could be like a... Oh, God. There's been like a pee party, for instance, come dressed as a letter P, you know.
Oh.
You come as a policeman, a prostitute,
oh.
a pauper.
Oh.
Yeah, right.
Oh, so not golden showers.
I thought she said a tea party.
No, I thought she said a pee party.
She did say a pee
party. It did sound like a pee party.
She said a pee party.
Pee.
But like you come as something.
A pee. Let a pee.
Mm.
Right.
You could come as a policeman.
Yes, there you
or
go.
Or a.
Yes.
Or a.
What?
Platypus. Platypus.
I don't think you get invited back to someone's house when you're dressed as a platypus, though.
Yeah, well, that's what you think. That's what you think.
All right.
Anything goes at the pee party, darling.
Are you into platypi?
Platypoi.
Coming up next, your chance to win Nova's trip a day. A brand new trip up the grabs.
Oh, it's your story again. Oh, your story.
Oh, we're out of time.
Yes, we are.
I'm going to follow Clint's lead on this. We're out of time.
Help.
How could this? Every single day, we've got little getaways up for grabs. I love a cheeky little getaway. It doesn't have to be a big two-week trip.
No, you love little weekends away.
Absolutely.
And when you wake up in Melbourne this morning and it's pouring with rain and windy and cold, what better time to try and win a holiday?
Exactly. And we had a whole bunch of people go on the running on Friday to win a trip to Port Lincoln in South Australia. A little seafood lover staycation. Let's go to the phones and award the trip.
That trip is going to Olivia in Seaford. Good morning. Olivia.
Yeah, how are you? Oh, my God, I'm freaking out. Thank you so much.
No worries.
Congratulations. The trip is all yours, girlfriend.
Pack your bags.
Thank you. Oh, my God. I'm actually freaking out. I just, like, inhaled my own saliva.
Are you due for a holiday, Olivia?
I am. I haven't been on a holiday in so long, and my boyfriend and I... 9-year anniversary is coming up. So this is absolutely perfect.
Okay, don't tell him you won it. Yeah, don't tell him you won it. Just say you bought it.
Nothing screams 9-year anniversary like a prawn cocktail.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Seafood lover's dream.
Yeah.
Well, you enjoy that, Olivia.
I like a hot seafood platter.
Oh, yeah, you're not cold.
No. But you know when you get the combined one, that's good.
What a combined hot cold?
Well, like something they bring out the two.
I don't know about this.
Yeah, some restaurants, they'll do a little dual hot and cold.
Do they?
How do you do a hot and cold? On one platter?
No. Separate platters.
Okay, so they're not doing a two-in-one. It's actually two platters. You're just ordering both things. You're ordering two things. No one's doing a hot and cold. You're not having a cold prawn next to a cooked prawn.
Yeah.
Okay, you've got me there. You know when you order two things?
You got yourself into a mess there, didn't you?
Cool story.
Right. Don't you talk. Can we move on to today's trip?
All my stories have been great so far today.
Let's give
away another trip. Okay, today we could be sending you to South Australia to the beautiful Barossa Valley.
Oh, yeah, that speaks to me.
And this is your winning artist. Bruno. When you hear Bruno Mars, it could be any Bruno Mars song. You give us a ring here at Nova and you go in the running for our next Nova trip a day.
Barossa Valley.
Hot and cold wine.
Oh,
hot and cold seafood.
That's called red and white, but they don't mix them. Oh, they do, Rosé. Need that cold.
Got it there. Hey, coming up next, is it hide and seek time, Melbourne?
Hide and seek.
Nova's $250,000 hide and seek. The search for Jason DeLauren could begin at any moment, Melbourne.
This is it. It's game week.
Game week. Game on, Melbourne. Catch us if you can.
Bags are packed at any point. Could be now.
Could be.
It isn't.
It's not.
No.
It's not right now.
But it could be
during the day too.
Am I going to get a heads up?
We're going to pop up.
I'm not, am I?
No, we like cheeky. We like just leaving you here.
I know.
We're going to pop up. You're going to hear us live on Nova saying, the game has begun.
That's right. So we will leave the station and go to a secret location at some point this week. When we do, the game begins. $250,000. The money counts down. So the quicker you find us, the more cash you win.
Yes.
We're starting with $250,000. You just have to find where we're hidden in Melbourne, knock on the door and say, Jason, Lauren, come out, wherever you are.
And if you want to win as much money as possible, you need to know exactly when the game starts. And the only way to know, we're not going to be leaking it. We're not going to be publishing it anywhere. You will be listening to Nova and we will say, the game has begun.
Now, remember, we're going to be offloading clues as well. So, look, if you're sitting there going, look, I can't race around Melbourne and find you. I'm going to be working. Like, you can find us between 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. So you might be taking the dog for a walk after work, walk past, I don't know, you might have a little sporting club near your house or something.
Oh, yeah. The clues might just add up for you and you go, hang on.
See the door to the tuck shop and go, I might just knock on that door and say, come out wherever you are.
You would be hiding in a tuck shop.
You never know.
Jace?
Oh, I'm just eating the Ovaltine. I'll be out in a sec.
He's 10 dimmies deep.
How good's an Ovaltine?
Going to need a deep fryer.
We've got an air fryer.
Do you?
Yeah. Got a video sent to me over the weekend of the location, all decked out, ready to go. Because we're not taking anything in now, because obviously people will be watching for that. So we're all good.
Oh, you need to stop talking. I'm not saying a word.
Don't forget, pack your swimmers.
I've already packed.
Good.
Swimmers?
Yes. Leave that one with you.
There's a clue.
So, it's Melbourne's biggest game of hide and seek. People are going hardcore as well. Juzzy from Altona. This is formerly Juzzy the Poo truck driver, now garbage truck driver. G'day, Juzzy.
Hi, Juzzy.
Good on you, Juzz.
Good morning, guys. How are we?
We are good,
I believe. Are you going to be playing hide and seek with us?
He's putting a team together.
Team's already begun.
A team?
So, how many people and what's their jobs?
We've got six. So, we have a couple on media. So, stalking everyone's Instagram, right. TikTok, and Facebook.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm glad you said stalking our Instagrams. When you said we've got people stalking everyone, it's like this game's not fun anymore. Right.
Yep. Okay. And then what's the other team members?
Are you sure, Lauren? Like, are you sure? Because we do have a bird's eye view of you guys at the current moment.
Oh, on Clarendon Street.
Mean? It's darker than legal tint. I'm sure you don't.
Actually, Juzzy has sent us a photo before from outside the Nova Studios looking up. So it wouldn't surprise me if they're outside waiting to watch us leave. Mm. All right. Okay. So
I can confirm or maybe not confirm that one.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. So, Loz, when we leave, if you see a giant poo truck driving behind us, we know we're being followed. Right. Shane is also on the case. Shane, you've got a team together for hide and seek.
Hello, guys. Yes.
Hi, Shane.
We have team. Hi. How are you?
We're good.
That's good. We have a team Shandy. So we have Shane and Andy. Andy is looking after the east. He's a seeker.
Right.
And Shane, myself, is looking after the west as a seeker. And we have two on administration, both in Narre Warren.
Who's in the admin team?
We have wife of Shane Kelly and wife of Andy Christie.
I'm just out of curiosity.
The wives of Shandy. The Shandy Wags.
Do you normally refer to yourself in the third person, just in general?
No, not normally. Right, okay. Not normally.
Shandy.
He spells it out beautifully. Team Shandy. Good luck, Team Shandy.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, guys.
I like the sound of Team Shandy.
Yeah, is there a few Shandy shared in the meetings?
Yeah, absolutely. We've had a pre-meeting and we will be meeting weekly.
Oh.
Right, okay. All right, well, it's game week at any point. We could vanish.
Good luck, Team Shandy.
Yeah, and head to our location.
Thank God he's not paired with Bart. They could have been shot.
Oh, God. Clint.
I'm so glad he's not coming in.
Awkward. Awkward. Awkward.
That's awkward.
Speaking of the footy.
Yes, we all went yesterday.
Mm.
You took the boys.
Actually, thank you to Mason. He hooked us up with some tickets.
Good on him.
We're in the Collingwood family and friends section.
Oh, we now.
Yes.
Oh,
you sat near the great Nathan Buckley.
Yeah, Buckus was only a couple of rows
down. Buckus.
What?
What? Speaking of things that are awkward.
What?
People who actually don't know much about something, but they talk about it like they're an expert, like you. Buckus.
Buckus.
Buckus has never been called Buckus in his life.
Well, maybe it's starting today. What are they called?
Bucks.
Bucks.
Oh, that's why he didn't answer me. Buckus!
Don't.
That is awkward. When people, you do it quite often. You're a new football fan and you talk like you're an expert.
Excuse me, can you tell Buckers I'm looking for him?
Funny.
Buckers, want a chip?
Funny.
Two awkward things happened to the footy. Yeah. First one, got the boys some food and stuff and I'm like, Dad, just wants to grab a couple of beers. That funny little walk to your seat when you're holding two beers and trying not to spill them and your eyes are on the beers but you're not watching where you're going.
And you've got to walk down the stairs.
Oh, and you're trying to part the sea of people and you're putting your elbow in front like, please don't knock the beers.
And when you're carrying that silly little tray, it's even worse.
And the people in front are looking back like, don't spill them. Don't spill them down my back.
And you shuffle through the crowd.
Yes.
Yeah, it is awkward, isn't it?
Then you're in your seat. You're watching the game. One of the boys needs to go to the bathroom but you're not on the end.
And you got to shuffle through.
Oh, when people have to shuffle their legs.
We have to wait until there's a goal. Wait till there's a goal.
Oh, do you?
I always wait till there's a goal.
Yeah. Oh, can you stand up? And then some people are standing up.
Some people are not sitting down.
And we're trying to, like, I'm lap dancing them. I'm like,
you have to offer all of them an apology.
Sorry.
On the way through.
Sorry. And then you got to come back 3 minutes later.
Sorry, I'll see you in a minute. Sorry.
Good on you, Jim. Sorry.
I'm going to take awkwards away from the footy, although this did happen. I find it so awkward, and it's a social media thing, when, like, you're in an environment, like yesterday we're in a box at the footy and someone was doing, like, a video around the box, and you know the camera's coming to you, and you don't know whether you should just pretend you haven't noticed, or whether you do that little, Like, or smile.
Or you did a little, like, cheers. Oh, no. You like, hold your drink
here it comes,
up.
Here it comes, here it comes.
Is this candid or is this, hey, like, peace? Like, oh, no, you throw a peace sign. You're like, hi. I knew that was coming for me.
Or
and
thumbs
then you
up.
See it back when it's posted. Inevitably, you just want to die of embarrassment.
Yep.
I think we've all experienced this. Jace, you're sitting down for a meal.
Yep.
At a nice restaurant.
Yep.
Or at a function. And the waiter or the waitress puts your napkin on your lap. Sometimes they even shuffle, you know, they.
Yeah.
And then they put it on you. It's just so awkward.
It is awkward, isn't it?
If I see it coming,
you just
I grab mine. I do it myself.
But sometimes they put the soiled napkin for the next course back on your lap.
Oh, no, you can't be doing that.
Stop it.
That's on me.
They get it, they straighten it. And then all of a sudden, it's this little dance and hands you didn't ask to go there.
No, I don't like it.
Then
napkin yourself. But I think they do it because otherwise.
That's the worst.
Does that mean we're ready for dinner?
What about when they put the, if they haven't napkined yourself, and then they put the plate down and it's on top of the napkin, and then you're trying to wriggle it out.
Yeah, maybe that's why. Maybe it just means I'm ready to eat.
Another thing that's awkward that happened at the same time that we had that awkward encounter at that function with the napkins, Clint. Which is awkward, is when someone gives you flowers, but, like, you're not at home. They're not being delivered to your house.
Oh, yeah.
Someone, and you're, like, in a restaurant, or it's a thank you, and it's so nice, but then you've awkwardly got to walk around with flowers for the rest of the day or to your car. People are like, oh, is it your birthday? And you're like, no.
No.
Oh, no, no.
They're lovely, those flowers that you got.
Stunning flowers. They were beautiful flowers, but I was just awkward walking out of the function with my big bouquet.
God, that reminds me of an awkward encounter we had last year. When Ebony, lovely lady, we get her every couple of weeks. She's a cleaner, comes around and just helps do the bathrooms and stuff. Ed. She rolled in, she's like, bloody hell, all the flowers in this house. I meant to ask, your wife a florist?
Had someone died?
My dad.
Oh, Ebony, work it out, sis.
Oh, yeah.
Were they all white flowers?
No, it was mixed, yeah. Dad likes sunflowers, so, you know, I can see where she thought, you know.
Oh, that's not something that's awkward that shouldn't be. That's just awkward.
You are on the air with Jason Lauren. Clint's here from the newsroom as well, and he is changing his suit for Speedos. Big night tomorrow night, Stanners.
I'm really nervous.
So you are going to Brisbane to swim in the Australian Championships?
Well, not the actual Australian Championships, but a
celebrity
relay.
Don't forget, pack a sock.
For the front of the Speedo.
Yeah.
So it's a celebrity relay. Who's in your team?
Keita Alexander. The beautiful Keita Alexander who we had in the Nova Red Room. She does.
She'd be a good swimmer.
She's a real secret weapon.
What stroke?
Freestyle.
Everyone doing freestyle?
I believe
so. Or is that medley?
Nah, freestyle. Right. Justin Norris, a retired Olympic swimmer as well.
Who else is in it?
Carl Stefanovic, I think. Yeah, he'll be in it. He'll be like Eric the Eel.
Do you know, I bumped into, do you know Sam Thaide?
Oh,
the rugby league player.
Mm-hmm. Used to play for the Broncos.
Sammy. I bumped into him yesterday at the MCG.
He's doing it too?
He's a unit,
big,
mate.
Big boy.
Yeah, you're going to see.
Big boy. Who else is doing it? Michelle Payne, the Melbourne Cup winning jockey.
Oh, I can't imagine her being a good swimmer.
Well, she's so little. She's light.
Yeah, but she's an athlete.
So she'll just float through the water.
Yeah, she'll
go. Do you have to have really long arms and long legs to be a swimmer?
Yeah,
she's little. Compact. She'll be like a little platypus. Like.
She'll go all right.
No, right.
I'm pooing my ducks.
Don't do that in the pool.
Don't do that in the pool.
Go brown. Imagine that.
Everyone out.
They'll have that dye. You know that special dye our parents told us to be pissing in the pool? It'll light up like a Christmas tree.
Don't do that.
The swim championships have been cancelled because Clint pooed in the pool.
Can we cut away from the underwater camera? Cut away. So tomorrow night we'll be able to watch it on Nine.
On national television. What a treat.
What are you actually wearing?
Do I need to shave down?
Yes.
Like full shave down?
Yes.
Everything.
Well, you take swimming very seriously.
Yes. I'm going to shave everything.
Don't look at me while you say that. Are you going to shave your head?
Matty Horton.
Mac. He was the best down the slide yesterday as Peter Garrett. He was very funny.
I know. When he came out with the bald head, I'm like, has he shaved his head for the role?
No, he put a bald cap on.
Yeah, that's what you need to do. You need to fully shave down.
I think I'm in a swimming cap.
You're not in a swimming cap.
I'm in a swimming cap.
You've got the shortest hair I've ever seen.
They've got a swimming cap.
Okay. Well, in case you break a world record, you know.
Your Tinder's going to go off tomorrow night.
Oh, you look like a little
Oh, don't.
Little fish.
Don't.
I can't
I think I'm swimming the anchor leg as well.
What's the anchor leg?
The last leg.
Oh, no, put the swimmer last. Go
no,
first.
Yeah, don't, no, don't have you last.
Because then you have to stand on the side of the pool in your little peeny point as well. Everyone else has a turn.
Also, if all the other teams
once
win.
Once you've swum, you can wrap yourself up in a towel.
But if all the other teams finish, Clint, we're going to just be watching you. All eyes will be on you.
Yeah, you don't want to do that. Because then if you're last, everyone's like, oh, here comes Eric the Eel.
Do you know who else is in it? Darren Palmer. Judge the from the block.
He'd be fit.
He's got a rig on him.
And he'd look good in Speedos.
Yeah, he would. Mm-hmm. And he'd be shaved down.
Yeah, he'd be shaved down.
Yes.
Yeah,
do I need a tan?
You know what? I think Joel Selwood had a tan to go down the slide. Yes, he did. I was
he looked like the old bird on Something About Mary.
He'd had a spray tan.
Yes.
Why don't I give you a spray tan tomorrow morning on the show and then you'll be ready for your swim?
Let's do the wheel of tan.
Because if it goes wrong.
I'll get a tanner in here and we'll give you spray tan tomorrow morning.
If it goes wrong, no.
It won't go wrong.
Clint, if it goes wrong, it really will look like you shit yourself in the pool.
I'll get my friends from Spray Oz in here and they'll give you a spray tan on there.
No, I don't think that's
tomorrow night. No, you definitely need it. You can't be getting your winter coat out.
Hey, Mason Cox is back in the building. Coxie's going to join us in a couple of minutes to talk about the almighty Pies win yesterday at the footy.
Okay.
So listen, I made a bet with Clint yesterday. If the Pies get up, he's got to do a magpie sound effect every time we talk about the game.
It's not getting tiring at all listening to you do that turkey noise.
Don't give any heads up to Mason.
Can you just compare it? Have you still got the sound? Just to see if I'm sort of spot on. It's pretty good.
I'll do a magpie noise.
It's annoying. I reckon it's better. An annoying sound when you're trying to get to sleep.
Absolutely.
Hey, it's also annoying when you sit next to someone who does it all morning long, which is what I've been listening to.
Amazing day at the G yesterday. There was something when I grew up in Brisbane, and if there's an amazing memory I have from my youth, it's my dad taking me to like my first Broncos game.
Yeah, going to the footy with your parents is like, we did it every weekend. My favourite thing to do.
Yeah, it was really cool, and it was like something I hold on to, and we used to go all the time.
Mm-hmm. Flags, face paint.
Yes, yeah, it was rugby league face paint. Bit nuffy. And during COVID, as I mentioned on the show before, my boys and I really got into AFL.
Yeah. Well, it was one of the only things we could do. We were actually talking about it yesterday. Remember when there were no fans at the game and they started putting in fake cheers when they got a goal? And then you could buy a cardboard cutout of yourself to be.
Just sad. But we got right into footy and almost helped it and saved us during lockdown.
Yeah.
And so, you know, for the last couple of years, the boys have been watching the games on TV and stuff. And thanks to Mace, actually, hooked us up with tickets to yesterday's game. And I took my boys for their very first footy game at the G.
In the outer, not in a box.
Nope, not in the box.
That's how all kids should experience level it. In the outer, with the fans.
Level four, right up top, amongst the Pies fans.
Dog's eye?
Yep.
Did you have a 4-20?
Yep, I had a pie.
Yeah.
They had a couple of hot dogs.
Great.
Yeah. Hot chips, yet tomato sauce all over your hands as you shove your hand into the bucket to get the ones at the bottom.
And it was great. Like all morning, they were so excited. We went down to Coles. They bought their beanies for the big freeze. They were dressed in their Pies stuff probably since like 9 o'clock.
Oh, did they get up and get dressed
early? They
were
ready to go. The thing is, one of my boys has autism and can get quite overwhelmed in big settings. So we have to be so careful. Like if we... You know, say if you guys come over for a barbecue or whatever, and after a few hours, I'll be like, hey, mate, I reckon we just peel off and go read a book in a room and stuff like that. And, sorry, I didn't mean to get emotional, but yesterday was like a really emotional moment for me because taking him to the footy and watching him in a setting like that, and I could see...
Were you nervous?
Yeah. Really nervous.
Was he?
No.
Just beyond excited.
Beyond excited. I felt like I was sitting next to bloody JB at one point. He knew every player, wherever the ball would go. Like, because, you know, with autism, they're so smart and they know every detail. And he was so excited. And I was just, you know, after halftime, I was watching him, you know, starting to get really overwhelmed. And I was like, okay, let's get out on the high. So I was like, if we bail after the third quarter, because otherwise then he'll get too, you know, over the top. And I said, oh, mate, okay, I reckon let's pull up. We'll watch the last quarter in the game. And he was happy to go. May have bribed him with an ice cream, but he was happy to go. And it was just to be able to get out on the high and just have the most amazing day.
Yeah, that's why footy's so good.
And not have the fallout and everything. It was such a cool moment.
Yeah, and you know what? I reckon you're, I know you're very emotional now, but that would be because you've probably put off doing that and going to the footy for the fear that it'd be too much and too overwhelming.
Yep.
And you don't have to go for the whole game. Like, you go and get what you need out of it, and then you can take off home. But also, now you've done it once. Like, that will get easier and easier every time.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. You know? And you just you pick the moment to get out.
I can imagine the overwhelm in your house before you left, and the anxiety would have been from you, not from me.
I was mentally cooked yesterday afternoon.
And footy in this city, it does strange things to people.
Yeah.
And do you know what? I'm so glad, and it's been so beautiful to watch how into it you've got and your boys now by virtue of that. And now you get to share that experience with them, hopefully again and again. You're back for Collingwood, which is a little bit of an issue.
Yeah.
And everyone around us was awesome as well. They could see, you know, he was getting really worked up by the third quarter. But again, it's just the footy community. They were like, you know, good on you, mate.
Yeah. And you know what, Jace? I know that'll be a core memory for you, but he'll never forget going to his first footy game.
Yeah, it was really
ever.
Cool.
Jace will never forget getting the ice cream on the way
There's
home.
Also no way that he bribed Felix with an ice cream. No. Felix would have been like,
let's
Dad.
Beat the traffic.
Come on, Dad. Come on. If we go now, we'll get an ice cream on the way out.
We're going to get that bloody Cornetto, whether you like it or not. And you're going to enjoy it.
Good on you. Footy's great. It's a great game. It's a great family day out.
And a big thanks to Coxie, too, because he organised tickets for us. In fact, the man is in the building. He's back. And he joins us next. It is Jace and Lauren. Clint is here as well. And so is our boy. He is back from the mighty Collingwood Football Club. Mason Cox is in the house.
Coxie.
Gosh, it's good to be back. It's been a while. It's been a few weeks.
We have been worried sick.
I've actually seen all of you outside of this over the last 2 weeks, which is kind of funny at the same time.
Socially.
We've socialised.
Yes.
But we haven't had you on because you kept failing your concussion test.
Yep. Got to pass that.
So you've passed that now?
Yeah. The first one. There's multiple ones. So there's a bit of a schedule, I guess, you have to go through to be able to get back to playing. So I've got the MCL injury, which will keep me out for another five weeks at least. Yeah, the knee.
Another 4 or 5 weeks.
Yeah, probably. Just depends how it all kind of pulls up. But I haven't been able to do too much because the first thing you have to do is pass a concussion before you kind of even get to the rest of it.
What do you have to do in a concussion test?
Oh, we just went through it when you were out of the studio. Have a listen to this.
Yeah, so you got like 10 words, totally random words, like nothing to do with each other. He goes, repeat those back to me. And then chances are you're probably not going to get all 10, right? You have to repeat them back again and then the third time. And then he goes off and does another thing. He says, okay, count back from 100 by sevens, you know, walk a straight line like you're doing it from, you know, they do it whenever you're like driving around.
Sobriety test.
That's I'd pass that without a concussion.
Yeah.
And wouldn't have last night.
I wouldn't have passed last night.
Lauren and I were saying we should give it a crack on the air one way.
Oh, jeez. But then the thing is, you go back after doing all these other tests and he goes, do you remember the 10 words I gave you at the very beginning?
Oh.
Repeat them all back to me.
Oh, no.
So you're getting three, maybe four, because your mind's been doing something else. And
it's
actually quite hard.
And you've got a cut on your head with stitches.
Yeah, so
you had surgery because you were also posting about going into surgery.
So the game was on Friday. I broke a rib, bruised a rib, concussion, broken cheekbone, which is like kind of called the zygoma, and then the MCL injury too. So I think it was about 5-1 contest, really.
Jesus. So the surgery was for your cheekbone.
Yeah. So I didn't even know until we got back on Tuesday and I was like, I can't close my jaw. Can I try to figure this out? He goes, I'll just go get a scan. And he just looks in, it's a broken bone just right up around the cheek.
Well, your bone structure looks gorgeous. Okay?
Thank you.
They've done a great job.
He did a bit of work while we're now
getting. They've done a great job fixing your cheeks.
What's it like breaking a rib? Because we saw Christian Petrarca. We're in the wars, aren't we? Our boys are in the wars.
Last night, track did not look good.
So he apparently broke two, but what's it actually like? What's the pain like?
It just, like, every breath hurts. And you're like, trying to sleep and stuff. Like, it's so hard to get to sleep. Hopefully, he's gone in for scans and stuff, and hopefully it's nothing crazy.
Well, he got taken away in an ambulance, and it looked like he was on a drip as well.
Yeah, it can be kind of serious because you can, like, puncture a lung or you can have some kind of... I mean, like, last year, I thought I had a broken rib, but I had a lacerated spleen. I was internally bleeding. So there's, like, things that you can have that maybe didn't... you know, it feels like a broken rib, but there's actually more serious damage underneath.
They give you the green whistle.
So I asked... he goes, do you want the green whistle? I look at the doctor and I go... it'd be an experience. I was like, you know, I'll taste it.
Try it.
I'll give it a little.
Take the pain away.
And then our doctor said, no, you don't need it.
Oh, so I was like,
How were the boys after the game? Yesterday, the big freeze is a big day.
Yeah.
And I feel like the D's fans went into it far more confident than the Collingwood fans, and you guys were amazing.
You guys were quick, mate. Straight off the bounce.
We've got a shorter team with a few tolls out, so I think you could definitely see that in the game. But, yeah, it was an incredible win. Like, the day is just amazing. I mean, I think everyone was there, and like to see the sliders go down and how much money that was raised. It's a real feel good moment.
Yeah,
I think
is,
in Melbourne,
it?
You know, and people from Sydney had come down and everything else. Like it's become such a big event. It's a credit to the Danahers of what they've been able to do.
Now it's funny you say that you had a little team.
Imagine him going down the slide. Big boy. Big boy, little slide.
I'd like to see it.
I'd love to see it.
Yeah, you'd be standing up in the pool at a big ankle deep water.
Yeah.
It's one more on footy just very quickly. Is Melbourne done?
No, I think everyone goes through a bit of patches. Like they had the Alice Springs game, they had a loss in, and then this week. But I think everyone knows that Melbourne is like definitely a finals team. They just, you know, maybe have to tweak a few different things with some players that have had to move around, and you know, Lever's out at the moment. So there's like now Petrarca's maybe injured. So you just kind of shift magnets and figure out how to win games. And I think that's just kind of part of it. I don't think like two games and all of a sudden you're like, oh,
seems like
wow,
Collingwood
totally,
deal with
totally
adversity
different.
More than better than Melbourne.
There's a lot we do better.
I was watching the start of the game where you run through the banner, and Collingwood's banner was like miniature. It was like half the size of the Demons.
It's what we do with it though, Lauren.
Are you guys saving coin on the banner?
We're earth friendly. We're eco friendly over at Collingwood.
Or is it because all the tall players were out, so they just made a little lower?
I don't think the big banner helped Melbourne. So.
No, it didn't. But Collingwood's banner was.
I have to go into the game.
Yeah, go. Mm-hmm.
Here we go.
I love a gripe.
Here we go.
If we're going to do the banner,
yep.
Can we actually run through the banner?
With some gusto,
I saw Max Gaunt run up with his little fingers and rip a little hole so it was already done.
Because it's like masking tape. You don't want to get like clotheslined.
Some of them are like going under the banner. Some went around it.
I think they've got slits. So there's actual a slit in the banner.
I want
to
see him burst through.
And some people go around it.
I want to see him burst through like someone jumping out of a cake.
What do you do? Do you go through it or under it or over it? You could almost high jump over it.
Funny you say this. I'm the last person through. So I let everyone else break the banner. Yeah. Therefore, there's plenty of height for me to get through.
Yeah. Do you duck?
I do duck. I duck under, and then it's like a bit of tradition for myself and Brody Maracek to give a handshake.
Yeah, because people have like weird superstitions, right, with the banner.
Yeah.
Some don't run through it at all.
In like 2018, our banner disintegrated on the grand final.
That's right.
If you remember
before the grand final.
And everyone's like, oh, it's a bad omen.
The cheer squad lady was in tears.
That's right.
Because Fox was lovely.
To be consoled by Buckers.
That was their pride and joy. They had one job, Mason. One job, and it blew apart.
Pull that up with the ropes yesterday. I was like, I'd love to see these people putting a tent up.
They're strong. Because the wind blows in it on the banner.
Before we let Mace go,
can't you just stay for the rest of the show?
I was just thinking, we should
stay for another one.
We should sneak him in for hide and seek.
Oh, can you imagine sneaking that in?
I was about to say that. I was like,
let's smuggle in the biggest human we know.
We'll get a magician to saw him in half, take him in two pieces. All right. You're happy to you're welcome to stick around.
Yeah.
But we need to celebrate something. The other day you did a post. 10 years since signing with the Collingwood football team.
Wow. Yeah.
And we have spared no expense.
Well, let's go.
Oh, it's a beautiful cake we've got for you.
Gosh, this is home baked.
It's got the number 10 on it, and it is a blueberry muffin from the
smoke detectors in here.
Don't set off the smoke.
Someone's
detectors.
Actually eaten a little part of
someone's
this already.
Someone's taken a bite.
Jess had a nibble at it.
Do I make a wish or something?
Make a wish and then blow them out before the smoke alarm goes off.
Nah, I'm going to let it fry. I'm just kidding.
Yeah, I'd like to get evacuated today.
Happy 10 years, mate, for the Collingwood football team.
Well done.
And in Melbourne.
We love you.
It is just gone 8:13. Mace is going to stick around. We've got the 5K question coming up next. If you want to play, 13:24:10 is our number. One question could win you $5,000 next on Nova. Mason Cox and the Pies are still hanging out. He has just given today's question a crack.
He did not know the answer.
Well, no.
Got close.
He knew half the answer.
Oh, he did actually, yeah.
I will take that.
You half the answer. Let's see how Steph goes. Good morning.
Morning, Steph.
Hi, how you going?
We're good. How's Glen Iris this morning? Windy and cold?
Yeah, there was lots of stuff in my back garden this morning.
Yeah, there'd be trees down everywhere. Drive carefully if you're on the roads this morning. It is wet and windy.
The old trampoline's still there. That always worries me.
I thought my house was going to blow away last night.
It was wild.
Mm. Hey, Steph, do you want to go an easy question for $50, medium question for $500, or roll the dice and go a hard question for $5K?
Look, I like to play hard, so let's go hard question yes. for $5K.
$5,000.
She's not here to muck around. All right, rules are rules. Steph, Lauren's going to give you the question. You get 3 seconds to answer. Okay? If you don't know, take a guess.
Here we go. Steph from Glen Iris for $5,000. The King's birthday holiday was yesterday. When is his actual birthday?
3, 2,
July 17th.
Well, sounded that's my confident. Brother's birthday, oh, the 17th of July. It is, but he ain't the king. It is the 14th of November.
Damn it.
Guess what, Steph? You weren't even close.
Like, okay.
Bloody hell.
Oh, well, it's true.
Wow. Oh.
Does that mean to say that?
Well, yeah, a little bit.
I mean, that's
all right. Mason Cox is here. You guessed the 2nd of November, so you were close.
Yeah, because what is it?
It's the 14th of November.
Hey, 5K question returns this time tomorrow, Steph.
Sorry, Steph.
Thanks for giving it a crack, doll. Have a good day, all right?
Thanks a lot.
No worries. She is filthy.
At me?
Yeah.
Watch,
who's your favourite, Steph, Lauren or me?
Or me.
Look, Lauren's got the same surname as me, so I'm sorry. I have to go Lauren.
Yeah, girl. See, he said you didn't like me.
You can't have family playing the 5 quiz question.
No,
right?
that rules you out straight away.
Sorry, you're a Phillips. Got enough cash.
Times are tough, obviously. That's plainly obvious, right?
Yeah. Things are expensive.
There are people battling to put food on the table right now. And look, I mean, I live probably a more privileged life in that, you know, I don't actually have a family, so I don't have multiple mouths to feed, so I get along okay.
Yep.
But I was trawling social media the other day, and something popped up on my algorithm that was made me think long and hard, and it was deeply heartbreaking. And it's happening right here in Melbourne as people struggle with the cost of living. I've got a photo here, Jace. I want to pop it up on the big screen. I've got a page for you each as well. That is Footscray, right?
Yep.
Footscray in Melbourne's West.
Wow.
They are queues of people lining up for food. So that's the queue for Food Bank. Their faces have been blacked out because obviously for privacy, and also for many of these people who are struggling, it is quite embarrassing and equally embarrassing and heartbreaking dealing with what is just a shocking reality for so many people. I read some stats this morning online which suggested, and this is extraordinary in itself, demand for Food Bank in Melbourne has risen by 200%.
Wow.
Can you imagine being one of those families, one of those parents, queuing in the middle of the night for food, to put food on the table?
Which you do whatever you have to do, but that's putting pride aside.
Yeah.
That's
Food Bank is amazing. They do big food drives and they do fundraisers and they work so hard.
Melbourne Initiative.
And you know what? There's so much dignity in the way they treat people at Food Bank.
So a few Food Bank reps have told me that not in their 93 or 94 year history have they seen demand for their services and their outreach.
Isn't that scary?
I want to bring in someone who, for him, it's close to home because he's an ambassador for Food Bank. He's also Melbourne radio royalty. Matt Tilley joins us on the line this morning.
Good morning, Matt.
Hello, Matt.
Hey, guys. How are you? I'm not an ambassador. That's my full-time job.
Okay.
Otherwise, if you're an ambassador, you get a special car. And
tell us about what's happening right now, because I was just staggered by these scenes, Matt.
It's really dire, Clint. Everything you said is true. They're the statistics we sort of deal with every day. I was at the footy yesterday and I was just looking at the crowd and thinking, gosh, we're feeding 65,000 people every single day.
Wow.
And that was pretty much, that's a reasonably full MCG, you know, and that's celebrated and feted as an amazing coming together of the community. But there's parts of the community that are queuing up, as you said, every day. And that can't be people who are homeless or people who are sleeping rough. That, as you said, that's families. That's mums and dads going without, putting their kids to bed, saying that they'll eat after they've gone to bed, but there's no food in the house.
Mm.
And, you know, those numbers are huge. You can't get your head around 65,000 people a day, but we meet them every day. We see those queues. We go out and do our markets, our mobile supermarkets. And, you know, you just meet people and you talk to them and there's incredible relief.
Mm.
You know, see it in their faces when they get fresh fruit and veg, which they find the hardest thing to afford, believe it or not.
Is it all mixed age groups? Doesn't discriminate, doesn't matter.
Doesn't discriminate at all. I met a dad the other day. It was just a heartbreaking story. He was in regional Victoria, been made retrenched. They moved to Sunbury because he managed to get a mature age apprenticeship. But he's got a wife and two kids, so you know what apprentice wages are like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But he thought, I can't sit around doing nothing, and he wants to work and he wants to build a future for his family, so he's looking down the road. But they can't even afford a car, so in his smoko, he rides to this market to get some food to feed the family that night. And you know how cold it is this morning? Most of these families are now going, well, once our first power bill comes in, we're either heating or we're eating.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Hey, Matt, for people who aren't aware of the food bank service, I know you're saying you've got 63,000 people you're feeding every day, but there would be a lot of people out there that still don't know about food bank. What is the process? How do people... Yeah. You don't have to register, you can just turn up, right?
Yeah, look, it's a great question. So we're about the size of two Bunnings stores in Yarraville under the Westgate Bridge.
It's an amazing facility out there.
Yeah, you've been out there.
Yeah, I've been out a couple of times.
And so we're like the Costco for the charity sector. So there's over 550 charities right across Victoria, Salvo's, Binnie's, and all that. And they basically order their supermarket shopping off us, fresh fruit and veg and all that. And then that's where people can go. So if you go to our website, foodbank.org.au, there's a big button on the front page that's find food. And you just click on that, put your postcode in, and then you'll be able to find the places that you can get to in the hours that they're open and things like that.
So, Matt, we're looking at this photo and it's staggering. The queue in Footscray, it must be hundreds and hundreds of metres long. And as Jay said before, it doesn't discriminate clearly. What are people telling you and food bank staff? Obviously, the stories are varied, but how are they when they present?
Well, people, they're often very embarrassed. So at least 60% of the people we've seen in the last year, and we've jumped from 50,000 a day to 65,000 a day just since last winter. So at least 60% of the people have never had to reach out for food before. So they're a little bit confused. They're incredibly embarrassed.
Yep.
And so we just want to put our arms around them. It's all about dignity and respect for us. And so we try and give them foods they're familiar with, you know, brands that they see in the supermarket, and with a smile. Because they're terrified. You know what it's like. You know what it's like to be hungry. Like you know, you haven't eaten, you're starving, you get a bit angry, a bit edgy, and stuff.
Yeah. So
they're dealing with that, but also they're dealing with the fact that they don't know, like, when's this going to end?
So
when will I be back on my feet? When will I be able to look the kids in the eyes and know that I'll be able to feed them for the rest of this week?
So you can turn up and get what you need, though, or do you go and you get everyone gets the same box? Or if you're just like, I actually, you know, we've got non-perishables, we just need fresh fruit, or the other way around, can you turn up and get what you need?
It depends where you go. As I say, that find food button is really your best indication of what you might need. So obviously there's always pantry staples, rice, noodles and stuff like that.
Yep.
But we've got a lot of little cultural enclaves around here. And you know, you find people who come from Southeast Asia, if you give them a box with pasta and tomato sauce in it, it's not disrespectful, but it doesn't really meet them where they need to
be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we always try and do it. But by far and away, and we get this all the time, and that photo is very confronting, particularly with people's faces blacked out. So that's not a photo we put out, but we see it all the time.
Yeah.
And people are very quick to judge. They're like, oh, that person doesn't look like they need food. You know, but the number one thing we hear every single time, particularly from mums, is, oh, my God, I am so desperate to give my kids fresh fruit and veg.
Yeah.
We just can't afford it.
It is like we're paying 54%
more than the world average for fresh fruit and veg in this country.
It's actually more expensive.
In a farming country.
To feed them right. Than just load them up with crap food.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hey, Matt, the other part of me goes for the other part of us that can help.
Yeah.
How can, because I'm looking at that photo and the first thing that comes to mind is,
What can I do?
Like, what can I do?
We've got a lot of very generous listeners who might be able to help.
It is about donation. So the other thing is, out of COVID, supermarkets and supply chains and distribution centres have got really smart. Since we're punching on over toilet paper and stuff, they've really got the supply chain sorted. So we don't see a lot of leftover and a lot of mistakes like we used to.
Right. Mm.
So we're having to spend $5 million a year on supplementary food. That's on top of, like, we get 16 million kilos donated, manufacturers and supermarkets. But we need to spend $5 million on top of that getting, you know, the wonky bananas, the bulk packed down rice that we can pack down into clear plastic bags and stuff. So foodbank.org.au is the website, and you can click on there and donate any amount. And you know the beautiful thing is, any donation you make, I've done a lot of work on this. Oh, I haven't, because I'm hopeless.
Right, yeah.
It comes down to every dollar donated, two meals created. So, you know, $5, you're feeding a family.
That's
and
great.
$5 is a latte.
Yeah, that's a good point. That's so true.
Hey, Matt, I know you head up fundraising for Food Bank. You're also a great ambassador, mate, and your heart is very much in the right place. Thank you so much for everything you do, and thanks for joining us on the show this morning.
Oh, pleasure, guys. Thanks for your time, and thanks for everybody who helps us out.
Good on you, Matt.
Thanks,
good to chat,
Matt.
Mate.
Cheers, guys.
He's doing bloody good work with
it. Makes you think, doesn't
it? Food Bank are an amazing organisation. There's a lot of volunteers down there as well that are working tirelessly to help.
I'm so glad you brought that to the table. Because that is an absolute
wake-up
call.
As you mentioned, you know, and I did as well, you know, we live, thankfully, very privileged lives.
Well, you know what I want to do?
There are people who are really battling.
To me, I want to show the photo to the kids tonight and go, hey, when you're not eating dinner or, you know, you're just leaving leftovers and everything, you're not caring about, you know, what's coming out, look at this. You know, it's a bloody reality check.
Foodbank.org.au if you can and you would like to donate. That's
all right.
Where you do it.
It is just gone 23 to 9. We'll check your underwork. Latest in news next. And Mason Cox is back and he's got questions. We're on.
Hide and seek.
Hide and hide and hide and seek.
Nova's $250,000 hide and seek. The search for Jason DeLauren could begin at any moment, Melbourne.
That's right. It is game week. At any point this week, we could just up and leave and we'll be out of here in some super fast cars as well from Lexus of Brighton. You can make a dynamic entrance, the Lexus LBX City SUV. You can catch it at Lexus of Brighton along the Nepean Highway. So we're going to be hiding somewhere in Melbourne.
Anywhere. And it could happen at any time.
Absolutely. And $250,000 on our head. But you want to find us quick because the money counts down.
Yes.
The quicker you find us,
the more you win.
You got it. And don't forget, listen to Nova for all the clues and save this number in your phone because we want you to text us while you're out hunting. 0459-888-100. That's 0459-888-100.
Text us and tell us where you think we are.
All you have to do is knock on the door and say, Jason, Lauren, come out, wherever you are. Keep your eyes open around your suburb and stuff as well because you could walk past, I don't know, buddy, local dry cleaner. And it could look shut down.
We might be out the back.
Knock on the door. You never know. Say, Jason, Lauren, come out, wherever you are. And we could with the money.
Think about the things we like. Okay, stop talking. I just looked at me then.
Stop talking.
Sorry. Just pretend I never said that.
Mason Cox from the Pies is still in the studio this morning. Would you be up for us sneaking you in?
I don't know who's smuggling people, but it is going to be a heck of a job trying to smuggle guys almost 7 feet into a secret hideout.
You won't stand out with a hood on your head. Not at all.
As a kid, being so tall, were you terrible at hide and seek? Because they'd be like, Mason, we can see you behind the couch. You're
just the
gate,
the tree. We'll never know. I was always back center in every class photo. I will say that.
You would have always been back center in class photos.
I'm not saying we'll be able to answer them all, but any questions? Because you're technically playing for the listener right now.
Oh, I've got a question for you after that.
Is there any questions for us regarding hide and seek?
I think like you'd want to know kind of, obviously you try to narrow it down from place to place.
We've said we're not hiding in a school, we're not hiding in a hospital, and we're not hiding in a house. Mm-hmm. So it's not like we've just, you know, booked a house.
Yeah, we don't want people going and knocking on people's doors at 6 p.m.
Just thinking about the Collingwood Football Club. There'd be a lot of little function rooms and different doors around
little
the place.
Doors
and stuff.
We could hide in.
Yeah, it'd be a lot easier to sneak me into my work.
Yeah, and there's showers. They've got the big grouper down there. They could cater all our meals. There's food.
We're at the BP on Bluff Road, just up from Meth Coles the other day, and we're just in the car park there. And my son looked up and they had one of those Jets gyms, 24-hour gyms, and he's like,
"Oh, Jace won't be hiding in there." You can rule out 24-hour gym. But speaking of gyms, I'm a bit worried because we don't know how long we're going to be in there for. Mm. I'm trying to be fairly healthy at the moment. What can I be doing while I'm locked in so I don't have to get rolled out of there? Because when I'm bored and I'm sitting, so I just eat and I don't want to do that. Should I be doing planks?
I would love for y'all to do a full Zumba class.
Oh, yeah, like Zumba.
Zoom chat Zumba.
Zumba?
Maybe a bit of that.
We need to do that thing they tell you on the aeroplane so you don't get
DVT.
Deep vein thrombosis.
Yes. Yeah.
Well, I'll run you through, because I'm going to be on the outside. I'll run you through.
Can you take us through some fitness classes?
Yes.
Mm. I was going to try and get like Luke Zocchi or someone on to give us a little workout while we're in there.
Yeah. Oh, my God. I might come out looking like Chris Hemsworth.
Doubt it.
We're going to need more than a few days.
we're not hiding out at a plastic surgery. At a plastic surgeon. Maybe you look like him in Mad Max. You could come out.
I'll tell you what. How about this? Because we could go in at any point, right? Mm-hmm. But we're definitely going in this week. If we last a couple of days, we won't do it on the first day because I think it's too risky. But if we last a couple of days, are you up for us trying to sneak you in?
Yeah.
You don't have to stay.
Yeah, question mark. How long is it? Do I have to stay to the end? Because I do have to go to the train for a little bit and check it out.
Yeah. We'll be living there.
You know why he's asking you to do this? Because he's going to say, can you drive through on the way and bring it in?
I just was thinking, I was like, I do owe you Maccas. I mean, last time you have given it to me, I feel like you need to return it.
Any idea how many nuggets I could gaffer tape to that man's body under a shirt to get him in?
Mace will arrive and Jason will be like, I've just got these jumpers for you to sign.
All right, well, the game is on
Fox merch.
At any point this week, and if we survive a couple of days, we're going to sneak Coxie in.
Huge. I'm excited for this.
All right, so keep your ears on Nova 100. Keep watching our socials. We could disappear at any time, Melbourne.
We could disappear.
Damn it.
We could also disappear at any time. I like the word disappear.
Here's a segue for you. Coming up next... Words you can't say. Hey, coming up next, it's our favourite segment.
It is the time that we laugh with you, but sometimes at you. No, not at you.
That's right.
Sometimes at you.
It is also the time you don't want to make a stuff up like I just did. Keep watching our socials. We could disappear at any time, Melbourne.
We could disappear.
Damn it. It is words you cannot say.
That's it.
I love this segment.
So do I.
And like you said, we laugh with you, not at you.
Except I'm going to cross to our producers in the phone room now. Who was in the meeting the other day when Jace goes, maybe we could do something with an ambulance?
I was there and it was ambulance.
Ambulance. We'll just get an ambulance.
And then he tried to correct himself and goes, ambulance.
Ambulance. No, I said ambulance. Say it.
Ambulance. 13, 24, 10.
There's an ambulance on the way.
Is there a word you cannot say? Give us a call. It's our favourite segment. We do it next on Nova 100.
Be very, very quiet. I'm hunting wabbits.
It's wabbit. Words you can't say.
Yes. Pick a ball.
Now, remember, we're laughing with you, not at you. In return, if you're brave enough to call, I've got $250 Bailey Nelson vouchers up for grabs. These are beautiful glasses. They're shaking up the way you get glasses with friendly optometrists and Australian-designed frames at fair prices.
They do great sunglasses, great frames, Bailey Nelson.
Bailey Nelson.
So do I need, like, bung eyes to go and get them?
No, they do sunglasses as well.
Yeah, or you could just get frames with no...
They also prescription. Do those,
we could do blue blockers.
Yeah, blue. What is it called?
Blue light blockers.
Yeah, for the computer.
So yeah. I would like. Yeah, how do you reckon I'd go with?
Good glasses. For travel on the plane. They say they help you stop getting jet lag if you wear them on a plane.
I like the big
wind glasses. Don't.
What about Tim Watson? Is that his name?
I don't know about his glasses.
Look like science goggles.
Yeah, they're not good.
Have you seen Martin Scorsese?
Scorsese.
Words you can't say.
The big frames. I tried them.
Oh, the chunky ones.
But I look like the guy in Up.
Yes.
You would. You would look like the guy in Up. You are a bit like the guy in Up. Yep. You look like him.
With the balloon house. He's grumpy. Imagine me with glasses. Who's got glasses?
Hang on. You actually look like him.
Yeah.
Up. Let me Google.
Perry's got glasses. Perry can Abadio I borrow your glasses?
Oh, my God. The guy in Up is you.
Nando's, can I borrow your glasses,
here he
please?
Comes. We want to see him in glasses.
This is looking into our future.
I need the big thick frame.
Are these quite? Oh my God!
Oh no, he's got little. He's got little round glasses on.
You look like the kid in Jerry Maguire.
Do you know the human head weighs 3 pounds? Meanwhile, poor Perry over there, who's giving you his glasses,
he's
can't
blind.
See.
Marco.
Good on you, Pez.
Thank you, Nandos.
All
right. Words you cannot say. 13.
Oh, that's what we're doing, yes.
Scott Hayes, eh?
Sorry, I got distracted by the glasses.
All right, 13, 24, 10. Here's some of the ones we've had in the past.
The trains go along the Whaleway track.
Oh, the Whaleway tracks.
The Whaleway tracks. Oh, that's a bit cute.
Look, I'm a security guard and I can't say ambulance. I have to call the ambulance.
I'd like a glass of Cordial.
Cute. It's actually quite cute when people can't say a word.
Ambulance will get you.
Ambulance will get you.
13, 24, 10. Let's go to the phones.
Karen from Moralbark. Well, that's a mouthful. Moralbark.
Moralbark.
What word can't you say? Can you throw it in a sentence for us?
That prize is phenomenal.
What was that?
That prize is?
Phenomenal.
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 No, you what? Said it wrong too.
Phenomenal.
That's not
phenomenal.
The word. Yeah.
Phenomenal. Yes, I'm saying yes. The same thing as you.
No, you're no, not. No, you're no. Saying you're double N.
What about when phenomenal. There's an when there's an amazing star show in the sky? It's a
phenomenon.
Yeah, phenomenon.
Phenomenon. Phenomenal.
Yeah, can't say that
you
either.
I was saying,
Jace no, got you there. Didn't. Good on you, Karen. That's a good one. Phenomenal.
I'm saying the
you,
same.
Yeah, you repeated thing. The same thing Karen said, bro.
Phenomenal.
Yeah, you got there now.
You got there now. Right. You've retrained your
mind. Oh, well,
you
19
Karen.
Turns.
That's on Karen.
She led you down the garden path.
Well, Karen's get a bad enough rap. Don't get stuck into her.
Let's go to Alicia. What word can you not say using in a sentence?
I like to have a snack on pistachios.
That's a good nut, by the way.
What is it?
I'm sorry, what?
Cheetos?
No.
Pistachios. You know the nut with the shell on the outside?
Pistachio?
Oh!
Yeah, pistachio.
Pispachios.
Pistachios.
It ranks very highly on my nut scale.
They're right up the top of my nuts. You know that. I love
nut chat. They're delicious.
A pistachio gelato is possibly the nicest flavor you can
get. No, I think a pistachio should stay in a nut and not venture into the ice cream world.
Have you had a pistachio gelato?
I have, and I didn't like it
because
it tasted like nuts.
You'd be the only person.
You need the salt that comes in with the shell.
Yeah.
You need to give that a suck. Good sucking.
No. Messina. Do a great pistachio.
Remember,
gelato.
I had all my nails broke off, and so
broke off.
Broke off. Did I say broke off? They broke off, and so I got the pre-shelled pistachios. No, just the kernels of
the
pistachio.
You know what? That's a
kernel.
I'm going to start calling them that now.
Pistachios.
People just think
I
I'm
can't
cooked.
Even remember what they used to be called anymore.
Mary in Ballarat, what word can't you say? Put it in a sentence, Dale.
Okay, first thing, welcome back, guys. I'm glad you're back on air.
Thanks,
Thank you
Mary.
So much, Mary. It's bloody good to be
Love
back.
Love the three of you. Listening to you on the Nova app, amazing.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah, listen on the Nova app, listen on the radio.
Yeah, my word is, my ethnicity yes. is Australian.
You what, sorry?
My ethnicity.
Her ethnicity. What's your ethnicity?
Ethnicity.
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 Oh, my God, Chase.
Ethnicity.
Ethnicity. That's even worse. It's no, it's ethnicity, isn't it?
Ethnicity.
It's because they put it in your mind and you start saying it the wrong
How
way.
How do you say it, Mary?
Ethnicity.
Ethnicity.
Yeah, almost got there. We should call this words Jace can't say.
Yeah, no, I know, but he catches it. It's like does. It's contagious.
13, 24, 10, we're doing words you cannot say.
Georgette. What word can't you say?
Georgette.
Georgette, is that your name?
Like a courgette. Yes. Yeah, right.
Georgette. It's a beautiful name.
Yes, I'm here.
Yes, what word can't you say?
I can't say the suburb, Montmorency.
I'm sorry.
It's near Eltham.
Yeah,
near Eltham. What is it?
Montmorency.
Montmorency.
Yes. How do you say it, Georgette?
Yeah. I can't pronounce it properly. It's Montmorency.
Montmorency.
I cannot pronounce it, so I just call it Monty.
Yeah, Monty's great.
Good.
Give it an abbreviation. It's very Australian to do that.
Wouldn't want to be living there.
It's part of our ethnicity, to shorten words.
Lindy, on 13, 24, 10, what word can you not say?
I can't say, you know, you go to work,
supervaluation. Say it again.
So just super, you know. Super.
Yeah, just super.
Yeah, what's super short for?
Superannuation.
Very important you top that up. Superannuation.
Oh, the superannuation confuses me.
Absolutely.
Yeah, you're going to need it one day.
Yeah, but I know. But you know, like. It's all spread out and
Lauren
different jobs.
Lauren will blow her super in the first year.
You got to get it all collated.
Mm. Yeah, you'll blow it on a cruise.
Yeah, you will.
You'll be on a Viking river cruise.
Paul, should we go to the buffet or the casino today?
No, maybe take the show.
Yeah, you will.
I'm going to be cool.
You're a cruise girl.
You'll be buying a necklace in every port.
Cruise. Cruise. Hey, guys, we always say it. We are spoilt for live music in Melbourne, and we're about to get more. Dean Lewis.
I'm a long way from home.
God, he's got a voice on him, doesn't he?
He
does. He is on the way to Melbourne. Rod Laver Arena in November. You can hit TEG for all the details. This song got me when this came out.
I know, but they've remixed it. He's done like a David Guetta remix or something.
Yeah, it's like a party one. Have you heard it, Clint?
Yeah, it's such a sad song.
No. And you? Yeah, do you know Dean Lewis used to work at Channel 9?
Yeah, I
did. What do you do there?
In lighting.
That's
or
right.
Staging.
Once upon a time.
Good tidbit. Exactly.
Thanks, Clint.
Thanks, Clint. What are...
No, I did know that. We interviewed him once and we talked about it.
Yeah, yeah. In fact, he was the one that told us, Clint.
He's part of the Channel 9 alumni.
Wow. You should get him on the Today Show to talk about it.
I used to work here, Dean.
This is the remix.
It's
the remix. Yeah. But it makes a sad song quite happy, doesn't it?
Wow. There we go. How do I say goodbye?
Get that into you, Melbourne.
All right, that is it.
Is it over?
Is it over? It's 20 past nine.
Oh, God. I just had to undo the top button of my jeans. I've got to go home. I ate too much Chinese food for dinner last night, I think.
Have you popped the top button?
I just undid my top button.
Have you got?
We went to family Chinese last night. It was so delicious.
I told you not to eat that Szechuan beef.
It was so yum. Oh, my gosh. No, I feel great.
Guys, there's something. You've just reminded me of something.
Go.
There's something I was working on.
Is it the fact that Dean Lewis used to work at Channel 9?
Is information I have been wondering.
No, it's something that I was working on last year.
Mm.
And it was a very specific piece of show merch that I think would come in handy for this team.
The claw machine.
I ended up parking it because we didn't have a show to actually publicise anymore.
Oh, yeah, that's
lucky
right.
We didn't spend our money on that.
I know, but now that we're back and we're on Nova.
Yeah.
Just something you just said just a couple of minutes ago reminded me.
About Chinese food?
Yep. Tomorrow, I'll reveal the piece of show merch that I've been toying with in the background and see if you guys give it the green light to go into production. It's not chopsticks.
I'm good with a pair of chopsticks. So did you say a pair of chopsticks?
Yep.
Is it a pair or just chopsticks?
It's just chopsticks.
Otherwise, it'd just be chopsticks.
You got it. It's the S that gave it away.
Chopsticks.
Okay, tomorrow, it's not chopsticks.
It's that Chinese food.
No, it's a piece of merch.
Stretchy pants.
That will come in very, very handy.
Oh, someone's alarm's
smoke
going
machine.
On.
Oh,
that's what's happening? Why is your alarm going on?
It's a smoke machine. We've got to go. See you tomorrow.
Oh, what a mess. Bye.
Jason Lauren.
Wake up feeling good.
On Nova 100.
Jason Lauren.
Follow them on socials.